Since the scooter with the SIP BFA engine is almost finished, but I still have 5 days left to the Nürburgring where I plan to do my first real test drive, I decided to change all my plans again and do it completely different, so that we can film even more episodes for you. How did you like that? The most time-consuming and also most nerve-wracking project that I have come up with is this selector box. You probably know the Liztor selector box. It has the advantage that it gets smaller from second gear and is in regular size for first gear and idle only. This has the advantage that you have a very small selector box from second gear and more freedom of inclination. You probably also know the Motorino Diavolo selector box that I have already introduced to you. That's the one that I've already installed. It's a sequential selector box where the gear changer always goes back to its initial position. That way, it's almost impossible to miss gears. What I have here now is a combination of both. At this point, many thanks to Christian from Motorino Diavolo, who collaborated with me and helped me to rebuild the selector box. Of course, he has done most of the work, because he knows exactly how this selector box works. This was important, because you have to pay attention down to tenths of a millimeter to make sure that all mechanics are still working fine. First, I'll remove the old Motorino Diavolo selector box. That sucks. Oil is leaking, more than I thought. Too late. I'll mark the outer shift cable with a cable tie. This one should be outward. Now you can see a problem. If you've used a Bowden cable, it splits easily, regardless of the condition. I could have soldered it too, but then this would still be here, and in the Motorino Diavolo selector box there is very little space for the Bowden cables, with very small cable nipples. That's why it also tells you in the instructions from Motorino Diavolo, use new Bowden cables every time. Not even used, already pulled out again. First thing to do is to take the headlight off and the bracket for the reset mechanism. Otherwise, I can't reach the lower Bowden cable and it will all be too fiddly. I hold the outer cable with the needle nose pliers so that it doesn't slip away. Now, the stuff can be put back together and then I can assemble the selector box. Pull this cable through here and then you can see how tight this is. You can barely get into this bend here. Getting this in here is already fiddly enough, and if the cable is split open or bent or compressed, then it's no fun. That's better. Most of it works now. What's not really working by now is that the selector box gets smaller by itself, so I have to check on that again. I think it's because of the spring preload, so I try to increase the spring preload a bit and see if it improves then. Ha! Look! In idle it gets bigger, and in first gear it gets bigger. That's pretty stupid for turns, but you don't take turns in first gear, but in third gear. Second gear, sorry. And in third and fourth gear, it also stays small, of course. I have to say, it works better than I thought. That's nice for once. I just have to see if it fits. It's all a bit tight with the BFA engine. Now it gets really exciting. The selector box works, but does it fit? Because it is not designed for the BFA, but for an original engine. Good thing that I have spilled oil here, that can be used right away for oiling the seal. It's exactly as annoying as I imagined it to be. It doesn't fit. On the top of the Liztor selector box are some screws. And in the same place where these screws are, the BFA engine case is thicker than an original. That means I can't assemble it like that. Just like always. It means I have to mill this down first. So I'll take the flywheel cover off and get myself some marks where I have to mill, where I have to create more space. Alright, so between the black marks I have to mill it down, best without messing everything up with chipping. Then I just need a cutter. I'll try it with a relatively normal cutter with a compressed air attachment and a metal cutter. Fortunately, these are very good milling cutters here, but I still don't know how well this will work. Safety glasses are always important. When you've been in the emergency room and some annoyed and overtired 25-year-old medical student stuck a spoon in your eye to get a splinter of metal out, then you can appreciate protective glasses. It's always recommended. Now, it doesn't quite pull in here because the screw is too long. Apparently, the casing height of the BFA engine is slightly different than the original. The screw that pulls the pad in here hits this, but that's not that bad. I can shorten it. I'll go straight to the bench grinder and shorten it. Remove screws again, deburr, and then build everything back together. First, I clean up everything before I fiddle around again. I'll quickly deburr this. Hopefully, it works now. Aha, first gear, okay. Second gear. And together. Great! As you can see, I've caused quite a bit of mess here because I still had to adjust some things, but luckily it works now. What I would like to draw your attention to, the Liztor selector box can be adjusted. It has 5 screws up here on the lever, 2 grub screws and 3 long screws, and with them you can easily adjust the lever. Make sure that the Liztor selector box is really well adjusted when you install it. The whole thing works roughly for me now. I still want to adjust the spring force of these 2 push rods here a little, so that it retracts evenly. But these are only small adjustments, otherwise it works. The most important thing right now is that I'm cleaning up after myself, and then I can move on to other things.